Jock Talk, a program where jocks get to talk, people have fun, and sets and funding are minimal. Here is your host, Wex Weed.
I'm Joef, our booth announcer. Thank you and good afternoon, and welcome to Jock Talk. Along with myself, our resident expert Howie Mika is along here to give us his valuable comments on the world of sport. How are you doing today, Howard?
This weekend and had one whale of a time.
That's super, Howard, because today on Jock Talk, we are going to go back a number of years, seven to be exact, to 1972, the fantastic Canada-Russia hockey series. Who could forget it? Everybody knows where they were when Paul Henderson scored that fantastic goal. Just before we get into that, Howie, I understand you were quite upset when you were not named as coach of the Canada team.
Well, by Jiminy's Wex, was I ever upset. By golly, I could have made myself a good grand, couple of grand on that one, and they just excluded me altogether. I know the most about hockey in Canada, by golly gee.
That is for sure. Anyways, I was feeling in a kind of nostalgic mood today, so I dug up some unbelievably exciting clips from the old archives, and if we're lucky, we're going to get to see them in a few minutes. We'd better after the trouble I took to get them. Later on Jock Talk, if we have enough time, we have a special guest, a very special guest who I'm sure...
Who is he? Come on, let us know who he is. The fans out there want to know, don't you, fans? You tell them. Come on, look at the phones. They're lighting up.
Tell
them who it is.
Shut up, Howie. Oh. Every week, Howie tries to guess who our secret guest is. Every week, he tries to get me to tell him who it is. But I'm sorry, I will not do that. I will not stoop that low.
Come on, Wex, let the fans know. Is it Mikhailov?
No.
Is it Pushkin?
No.
Come on, is it Marion Stachny of those Czechoslovakians?
No.
Is it Bobby Clark?
No.
Frank Mahovlich?
No.
Daryl Sittler?
No.
Lenny McDonald?
Let me just say to watch
Joe out Lundgren.
For how... It may be Joe. Let me just say to watch out for how critical you are, because we don't want you to step on any toes, if you know what I mean.
You gotta be kidding me, critical.
Well,
I'm not critical, never.
If we can get Joe and Toomey and Telecine to roll our first clip, I think we're in the business. And here it
is. There he is. Now look at that.
Opening ceremony.
Oh, a proud moment in my life. Howie, I think every Canadian felt the same way I did.
What were you doing in this particular moment?
I was taking a sip of my beer.
And here's the opening ceremony stop. Here it is.
Oh, okay, look at
great play.
It goes back into the Canadians end, and they take it right out. Watch this.
A great play by the defense, but up to the point, and there it goes.
Okay.
Goes up. Great shot. Great play. Great play.
Well, look, I was excited. No, I want you to watch Esposito. He changes hands on that stick.
A phenomenal play. Just
away.
Unbelievable.
Oh,
unbelievable.
Geez, that was great hockey action.
Great hockey. Can you believe that, Howie?
I know.
I understand that after the series, you wrote a book. Could you tell us a bit about the book?
Well, the book was called Why Can't the Czechs Check Closely Like Canada?
Yes.
And Wex, I happen to have a copy of it with me here today. Is it okay if I show the fans?
I think that is okay. Okay.
Great. Cool. All right, here it is. I changed it for Canadian release to Howie Meeker's Hockey Basics. Now, my goodness sakes out there, you can get this book for only $18, Kohl's bookstore, any bookstore, maybe even at the Ryerson bookstore. And so why don't you pick a copy up? It'll help support me and my family.
Yes, I think you need supporting too, Howie. You were very critical of the Czechoslovakian national team in that book. I was wondering why you were not too impressed by the way they play.
Well, look at those Czechs. They don't know how to check. I mean, it's in their name, but they just ignore it. Check, check, check. That's the key. And look at this film clip here. Look at the checking by the Russians. They check.
Great check. And a great shot by
look at Sinden.
Harry
Sinden. Intensity on the bench. Great. They're excited. Great. The Czechs aren't like that.
Great. And that was a very long clip right there. We had lots of time to talk about that one.
For sure.
What exactly impresses you about the two teams we saw out on the ice, Howie? Was it the unbelievable pressure they are under each and every time they step out on the ice? Was it the pinpoint passing, the fantastic checking, or was it the terrible punishment they have to endure each and every shift?
Wex. It was none of those things. By golly, those guys made more money in seven games than I made in my entire NHL career. And I checked.
Did you check, Howie?
I checked.
Good. Right, Howie. Tell us a bit about the Russian style of play that you saw there.
Well, look, I was impressed with the Russian style of play because they know how the game should be played. They're a great defensive squad. They score a lot of goals, but still, they're always checking. And checking is the key to winning those hockey games. So let's have a look at that next clip, could we? Come on,
Wex. Okay, it should be coming up. And now it is.
Okay, now take a look there. Roll it back, okay?
No, Howie, we cannot.
I'd like to see this one again.
Too complicated.
Okay, now look, they're down in there. I think they're going to score a goal.
Score.
Now, was it Cornway or was it
Scores! Excellent. Great goal.
I'm excited.
Celebration.
I'm really excited.
Celebration.
Oh, I, I'm so ecstatic about that just, one. And what
that
a great play.
A proud play. Moment in Canadian history, I think. And we'll dip to black and we'll back up again, Howie.
Why didn't they roll it back up there? I wanted to see it again.
It's a little too complicated for our crew. You see, we have John Toomey doing his best as he can up until it's in, but perhaps we need Andy Kuflau. And Kuflau, we'll get Andy up there to help out in Telecine. But what about leadership, Howie? In a short series like this, how important is leadership?
Look, I keep telling the kids in my hockey school, you gotta have leadership. Now, the Czechoslovakians don't have leadership. Canada does, Russia does. But the Czechoslovakians don't. All they got is this beer-guzzling, beer-bellied son of a gun, and he lazes around that ice. No leadership whatsoever, and he doesn't check worth a darn.
Well, Howie, it is very interesting that you should be so critical and so uptight about the Czechoslovakian national team, because our special guest today is none other than the captain and leading scorer of the Czechoslovakian national team, Muri Kaprila. Muri, come on out and meet Howie Mika.
Oh, how are you today? Hey, good to see you again, Wax.
Well, there's old Muri, you son of a gun.
Let me make myself comfortable.
Pull up a chair, Muri.
Pull up a chair, come on in here.
I love your book, it's one of my favorites.
It's one of my favorites, too.
Seaweed yourself in right there. Muri, let's get right down to it. I don't understand here. It seems to me you have a Finnish sweater on. What happened to the Czechoslovakian sweater?
You are very perceptive there, Wax.
Thank you.
You see, I was thinking about the leadership of our team, and I figured that in Prague we were not getting the leadership that we should have got, and in Finland they were looking for some leadership. I agree with you guys so much, and so I decided that Finland was the new place for me, and so I defected.
Well, look, and I'm interested, how the heck did you get out of the country?
I can't give away my secrets because I used the same one that the big Ned used. I think he said he was going away for a holiday somewhere, and so we just kind of snuck out.
Big Ned. That brings up another point. I understood when you were on the Czechoslovakian team that you and Big Ned shared rooms, and was it hard for you to part with your close personal friend?
That's a ticket.
Big Nimit.
Well, that's very easy for you to say, Wax. But let me say that it was so much fun being a roommate with Big Ned, because we used to go out away from our wives to go to the other towns, and the Big Ned would get around. He would really... All the girls would call him Big Ned, and that's why he got
kind
his name.
Kind of like what Howie does, too, but his wife would be very upset to know
that.
At
Muriel would like to hear it. Let's keep her cool.
Well, I saw Muriel. Oh, forget that one.
did you have a new nickname when you were in the Czechoslovakian?
Yes, they called me the Big M.
The Big M?
Oh, what?
Well,
whoops.
Bodies.
That's funny because we have a player in Canada who, Frank Mahavlich, who played...
That's a relative of mine.
Oh.
I want to ask him a question. Can I ask him a question?
Certainly, Howie.
Have you read my book?
Yes, that's why I decided that we have to check. And in this book, you say all the time, check, check, check. And so I decided that Finland would become the new Canada. The new Canada.
What, you mean like they're going to check like they're us? Gonna they're going to have good teeth?
The Czechs didn't check, but the Finns will check.
So...
Okay. And we'll collect a lot of paychecks, too, if we get over to the NHL.
What about your stay in so far in Canada? How are you enjoying it?
I was very disappointed because about 5 years ago, I heard that they had this really crazy movies on the station here called Channel 7 and 9, and then when I got over here, there's no movies at all except some East Indian movie about something over there in Calcutta, and I didn't see anything in that at all, which I thought I would.
Well, we're trying to get Howie Meeker's hockey school into that time slot. You know, I think it would be great Friday night entertainment.
But, Howie, I understand your show is canceled.
No, by God, I'm trying to sell it. I'm trying to sell it again.
Well, Muri, can you tell us a bit about your wife and how she is adjusting to a Finnish style of life?
Well, we first got our name changed. Really, it's kind of funny. I didn't tell you this, but Muri Kaprila is my old Czechoslovakian name, and now it's called Muri Kapanen. And so my wife changed her name,
I think that's about just
Don't
about
you
it.
Want to hear about
no.
my wife?
You better be quiet.
I haven't seen her for about 3
Thank
years.
Thank you to our special guest, Howie and Muri.
I haven't seen a lot
Thank
of
you
others.
Very much, Andrew.